Welcome back, guys. We're starting a new campaign. So, in the first episode, all I did was design my ship. So, we're about to start on a first battle. So, as always, I just set these to full. Because that's what you would do if you were playing a grand campaign. So, I like to simulate playing a grand campaign. We've still got a decent monthly balance, which is good. I've just put all of my ships into the same port, Emden. So, that way, they're all, I think anyway, they're all more likely to join each other in battle if they're in the same port. I don't actually know if that's the case, but I think so. Okay, so we've got Armored and Light versus Armored and Light, and they've got a torpedo boat. So we'll see how this goes on. I have no idea, if I'm honest. We've got another nighttime sky. Wonder if it's nighttime. Nope, daytime still. Right then, my light cruiser is 19 knots and my armoured is 18.5. They are to the north. Okay. So obviously I'm going to want to try and take out this torpedo boat if I can. Well, it's been that long since I've played 1890 that I can't remember quite how bad the guns are at shooting. I've got a feeling I'm going to have to get within torpedo range to actually be able to destroy him. That looks like him. Okay, let's see how it goes. Let's see if he's got torpedoes. Let's see if he has. No. So the light cruiser and the torpedo boat up. Well, we've landed some hits on him already. I'm quite surprised. So he appears to have two deck torpedoes rather than two rounds for one deck. Right, interesting. What about this guy? Two deck, two underwater, sorry, and two for each one. I wonder if he's gone front or back or left and right. Left and right, interesting. Well, I'm gonna have to start moving away from that light cruiser. My light cruiser's decided to put himself into a bit of danger, but he's been okay. He got lucky. So it wasn't too difficult dealing with that transport. I keep calling it that, torpedo bit. Wow! Okay, goodbye. That was a nice explosion. He had no ammo as well, which is meant to reduce the likelihood of an explosion. It obviously did not help him. Oh, before you sink, let me have a look. Yeah, no gun turret. Armor, that's what it was. The mistake the AI always makes. No armor on his turrets. So yeah, if you're ever suffering from lots of ammo detonations and flash fires, check your turret armor. Make sure that you're not going in with a ridiculously low amount. Really, your side turret armor should be the same as your main belt, and your top turret armor should be the same as your main deck, or higher. I like to have mine higher, just to make sure I get even more critical hit protection. Alright, let's have a look. He's 16 knots and I'm 18.5, so he isn't going anywhere. What guns he got? 2x2 7 inches. 14x1. Right, okay, so he's got a lot of 4 inches. It's a little bit dangerous to get close to. Although I have got a load on my light cruiser. What's his armour looking like? He's only got 0.1 on the top of his turret again. Not wise. Then again, I've only got 0.2. Looks like I forgot to do mine. Silly me. Well, I'd forgotten how boring 1890s conflicts are. Makes a nice change of pace from the 1940s torpedo invasion. Thank you. looks like he's playing possum. He has started moving again slightly, but now he's slowed down again. Fair enough. It is slightly odd behaviour, but I don't mind. That's a rough one. What did it hit? Main gun destroyed. I wonder if that was the 0.2 that I was talking about earlier that I forgot to increase. Well, we were lucky to get out of that one. And that was totally my fault for forgetting to increase that. So yeah, as you saw, I got a critical hit on his turret because he didn't armour his, and he got a critical hit on mine because I didn't armour mine. So make sure you put some armour on them turrets, guys. Three CA versus one and two CL. Should be nice and easy. I've no idea why the AI wants me to run away when I'm the one with the advantage. My god, 18 knots seems so slow. It feels like we're not moving. spotted the enemy now, anyway. So obviously the major threat is their torpedoes, which is why I'm just ignoring the armoured cruiser for now. But I am still quite concerned about all these transports firing all them guns at me, because although they haven't got great accuracy and they've only got one gun each, they do add up. Jesus, they've got six guns each, they usually only have one. Yeah, I'm quite concerned about them transports. I'm gonna take out these transports. I don't like the amount of firepower that they've got. Which sounds absurd to say about a transport, but it is what it is. It might be boring to watch, and I do apologize if it is, but I'm kind of enjoying the change of pace. I haven't played a 1890s campaign in so long. It's like watching everything in ultra slow motion. I've got to be careful here, because he is coming in rather close. He's actually really fast. He's got a 4-knot speed advantage over me. And I think this ship is probably in peril. Ooh, that was lucky timing. Because he was just coming around for a torpedo attack. He will probably be rather annoyed about that. Very nice. I obviously didn't do much talking during that, but what is there to say other than this is slow. What we got there? Didn't really take any damage. I've got a feeling that this campaign is going to be a short one. Because they're just going to want to quit. So, similar again. 2 CA and 1 CL. So, I've got a theory that if they're the one in sea control, you're the one that has to defend the transports. If you're the one in sea control, then they have to defend the transports. If both of you are in sea control, then it's random who has to defend the transports. That's my theory anyway. It seemed to work like that in the 1920s and 30s campaigns, I think it was, that I did. When I had my whole fleet in sea control for the entire time and I didn't do a single defend the transport, but every single one I was attacking their transports. Okay, northwest. Obviously, we're going to want to take out the light cruiser first to get rid of the torpedo. My only job is to make sure I don't get torpedoed. And I almost failed. I had one job. Scraped by the skin of my teeth. Always nice to get a flashlight. Wonder if it was main gun destroyed. Yep, main gun destroyed. It's nearly always main gun destroyed. I'd say 9 times out of 10 it's main gun destroyed. And then the other time it's oh, what are you doing? It's main belt. Why? Just why? He clearly doesn't know how to follow. I'm gonna have to move him out of the way. Nice and easy. Go another 1,759 to 5. Right, well, I think we'll call it a day there, but I can't imagine the next episode being too long because I think they're about to capitulate. So, thanks for watching, guys. Take care. See you soon.